Why does Spider-Man enjoy photography? Because he's a shutterbug! I probably deserve that. Yep, that one too. Welcome to 5 Points of Articulation, where I review action figures and then articulate 5 points to help you decide if you want to add that figure to your collection. The 5 points I discuss are packaging, presentation, posability, playability, and price. I'm Jason, and if you enjoy my content, please like, share, subscribe, do all the YouTube rigmarole. Today, we're looking at the comedian version of the Joker from Batman, The Three Jokers. Starting off with the packaging, it's a pretty typical multiverse box. Only real difference is the Three Jokers logo and the product shot on the back. Interestingly enough, it doesn't show any of the other figures in the wave. Either way, for packaging, I'm giving the Joker one whole point. Moving on to presentation, and the Joker stands at 7 inches from the top, and I love this thing. Although I don't have every McFarlane Joker, of the ones that I do have, this is my favorite face sculpt. He's got a floppy, wide-brim hat, shadowy, demon-like glints for eyes, and the grin itself is very grimy and very creepy. They even gave his hair a bit of a wash, which, considering how little of it you see, is a really nice touch. Moving on down, and most of the body is dominated by this trench coat. The leather texture is spot on, and it's fairly flexible. Underneath, he's wearing a black shirt and a gray tie, which for the Joker is kind of muted, but it really helps the rest of this to pop. A little bit of silver on the buckle would have been nice, but it's not a big deal, and I do like how floppy the straps are. Granted, I do wish that they could have continued that texture inside of the joints, but looking at it normal, it doesn't really bother me. Flipping it around, we can see more of that coat detail on the back, some layering here. Another thing that I appreciate is that they used a different shade of purple for the gloves and for the legs. Speaking of the legs, this one seems to be a little bit curved, and the thing that I probably love the most is that the wrist balls are nicely hidden. And moving all the way down, we can see his very fashionable spats. The concept of the story is that the Joker is actually 3 separate men, and each one has been responsible for a different tragedy in the Bat family's life. This Joker is the one who crippled Barbara Gordon in The Killing Joke. It's one of the scariest, most mature Batman stories ever written, and this is by far one of the creepiest, most unique Joker figures ever made. For presentation, I'm giving this Joker one whole point. Moving on to posability, and Joker's head's on a dumbbell joint. Can't really look up, but he can look a fair amount down. Little bit of tilt, and all the way around. Swivel hinge shoulders raise up that far. Slight amount of forward and back thanks to the McFarlane rotator cuff. Bicep swivel. Double jointed elbows. Very nice. And thanks to the McFarlane wrist ball, he gets swivel and hinge. Not surprisingly, there isn't any torso articulation, and while there is some waist articulation, I honestly wouldn't try it. The crotch piece is a softer rubber, so when you twist it, it starts to bunch up. While we're down there, he does have the typical McFarlane hips, quite a bit of swivel there, and thanks to the coat, he can really only spread out about that far. Pretty decent kick, though. Moving on down, he's got double jointed knees, ankles that hinge, and pivot, and toticulation. If it were me, this would have been a waistline, the top half would have been a solid piece, there'd be a dumbbell joint similar to Kang, and his bottom half would have been a soft skirt piece similar to Dr. Fate with some slits cut in the seams. As is, this is about the most dynamic I can get him. Don't get me wrong, I love this figure. In fact, he might just be in my top 3 favorite Joker figures of all time. Even so, for posability, I'm giving this Joker half a point. Before we continue, if you like this video, do me a favor and give it a like. I put a lot of love in these videos, and your likes help more people to see them. Moving on to playability, and Joker comes with this camera. It has the Three Jokers logo sculpted in it for some reason. Otherwise, it is actually pretty accurate to the one on the cover of The Killing Joke. He also comes with this crowbar, which is unfortunately not accurate to The Killing Joke. In McFarlane's defense, I will say it is at least a different crowbar, but really, he needs to be coming with a gun. And based on this gun holding hand, I'm pretty sure he knows that too. In the meantime, this one from Flashpoint Batman will do in a pinch. I also found this revolver in my accessory stash. I'm not sure what it's from. Pretty sure it came with the Arkham Asylum Joker, but it goes so nicely with the camera that I think this is pretty much going to be how I display him. For the uninitiated, the whole no gun thing is an unfortunate corporate mandate from Warner Brothers. I'm honestly kind of wondering if McFarlane planned on giving him a gun, but Warner Brothers told him no, or if he knew that going in and gave him the gun hand so that we could figure out our own accessories. But playability is more than just accessories, it's also about how well your figure plays with others. For a Batman comparison, here is in between the Battle Damage one from McFarlane Toys and also the Rebirth one from DC Collectibles. I feel that something in between the two would probably be perfect. Hopefully the upcoming Three Jokers Batman will fit the bill. Here he is with a Killing Joke era Batman from DC Direct, and a Nightfall Batman from DC Essentials. For a Harley Quinn comparison, we've got Arkham Asylum and DC Essentials by DC Direct / DC Collectibles. For a couple of Batgirl comparisons, here he is with the Art of the Crime Batgirl by McFarlane Toys, and the DC Essentials Batgirl by DC Collectibles. For some other Bat Family comparisons, here he is with the DC Essentials Nightwing and Red Hood. For a Robin comparison, here he is with a few different versions of Tim Drake. Tim Drake, by the way, is my favorite Robin. Also in the Robin department, we have Dick Grayson from DC Universe Classics, and Damian from McFarlane Toys. For a Joker comparison, here he is with Rebirth and Arkham Asylum by McFarlane Toys. Here we have the Joker from Batman and Son by DC Direct. Deceased Joker by DC Essentials. Alex Ross also by DC Direct. This pretty cool straitjacket one by DC Direct. And Legends of the Dark Knight by Kenner. Ah, what the heck? Here he is with my entire Joker collection. For a Creepy Clown comparison, here he is with Pennywise.
Can I take your picture for the school paper? I need one with a student in it.
Don't make me look ugly.
That's impossible. Say cheese.
Bah!
Peter, are you okay?
I'm fine. For a relative scale comparison, here he is with Pizza Spidey and the Spectacular Spider-Man. And of course, here he is with Stealth Iron Man. He might come with an accessory that's more appropriate for a different Joker, but the camera's perfect. And even without it, he's just a great general coat and hat version of the character that you can fit just about anywhere in your Batman collection. For playability, I'm giving this Joker one whole point. This leaves us with nothing left to discuss but the price. Of all the three Jokers of the three Jokers, this one was of course the most difficult to get a hold of. Fortunately, after a pretty clumsy rollout, he's now available at GameStop. And just $19.99, the Killing Joke Joker is a killer deal. For price, I'm giving this Joker one whole point for a grand total of 4.5 out of 5. For a look at another Joker figure, check out my review of the Deceased collection from DC Essentials, and sound off in the comments. If you've read the three Jokers, what do you think of the idea? I'll be back again real soon, but until then, play nice and have fun.